When you're building NLP application, you might end up using multiple libraries such as Spacy, NLTK, Gensim, PyTorch, TensorFlow, Hugging Face, and so on. Spacy and NLTK are two most popular libraries that are being used in any NLP application, and they tend to do similar things. So Baby Yoda is asking, if they are doing similar things, then what's the difference? Well, in this video, we are going to cover the difference between these two popular libraries. See, he's happy. The very first difference is that Spacy is object-oriented, whereas NLTK is string processing library. Now, you'll be like, what does that mean? Well, let's try it out. So I'm going to install both the libraries and show you a sample code. I have installed Git bash here. So if you have not installed that on your machine, you can just run, like, you know, download Git bash. So Git bash allows you to run Unix commands on Windows. You can do it on Windows command prompt as well. It's your choice. And I opened Git bash from here. So it just is command prompt, right? You can do the same thing from Windows command prompt also. You say pip install NLTK, and I'm assuming you have installed Python already. So you need to have latest version of Python installed. So now that install NLTK, you can now install pip install Spacy, and that will install Spacy library as well. Okay, it will take some time, but it will be installed pretty smoothly. You need to also download some packages for Spacy by running this command called Python-m Spacy download. So you are downloading all the packages related to EN. EN is English. So for English language specific Spacy models, see, it's downloading some Spacy models that you'll be using to write your code. After you have done that, you can run Jupyter Notebook, or the other way. So I'm assuming you know what Jupyter Notebook is, and you have installed Jupyter Notebook on your computer, and you can run Jupyter Notebook by running this command, and it will launch an interactive cell, you know, in a browser where you can write your Python code. I am running this in this particular library, in this particular directory. So make sure you enter into a specific directory, because in Jupyter Notebook, you'll be able to see the code of just that directory. And I have created a folder, you know, doesn't matter. You can do this in your root directory, and you will say new Python 3. Okay. So that is creating the new notebook. And now what I'm going to do is, in Spacy, I will do sentence and word tokenization. So here, import Spacy library. You can do it by doing this, control enter to execute it, and B shortcut to create a new cell. And you will say spacy.load. So this loads a specific package. So I want to download, I want to start using English, like the English core package for this particular use case. And you will call this object NLP. By the way, we'll go into more details later on, but right now I want to explain you the difference between Spacy and NLTK, and I want to show you by writing this code why Spacy is object oriented and why NLT is string processing, why it is not object oriented. Okay, so once NLP object is created, you can create a doc and supply a string. So okay, now I'm going to supply some string which you are going to like it. So see, Dr. Strange loves Pav Bhaji of Mumbai, and Hulk loves Chaat, Delhi Chaat. So So these guys visited apparently India and they fell in love with the street food. And here is the document because it has two sentences, correct? One and two. And we saw in a previous video that it's a usual practice that you have a paragraph and you want to split the paragraph into individual sentences and then individual sentences into individual words for your NLP application. It could be any use case. We'll look into this use case later, okay? Don't worry. But just think, you are building NLP application, you want to split a big paragraph into sentences. And this is how you do it in Spacy. You will just say for sentence in doc dot, by the way, you can hit tab also, it will autocomplete. Print sentence. See, it printed two sentences. So it split these two sentences accurately. And it is a little smarter. It is not just using dot, because if it was using just dot, you will get dr as a separate statement. But here, it understands that dr dot is part of one big sentence and it is not a sentence in itself, correct? So see, that's where you see the benefit of using these packages. Otherwise, I can write Python code and split everything by dot, right? But if you have things like etc dot, you know, your Python program will suck because it will start splitting sentences by every dot. So you need something smarter. So this is basically sentence tokenization in Spacy. And you are already realizing that we are using object-oriented programming here because we created this object. And now object has a property called sense and we're just iterating over it. So see, it's easier to write code this way. If you want to separate out individual words from these sentences, what you'll do is, see, it's very intuitive. For a word in sentence, see, it's like English. It's like I'm writing English and it just prints individual words from all these sentences. So this was a sentence tokenization. This was a word tokenization in Spacy. And by looking at the code, you can say this is using object-oriented programming. Now let's do the same thing in NLTK. I would say import NLTK. And in NLTK, if you want to tokenize, so you will say, from NLTK dot tokenize import, hit tab. See, there are so many tokenizers, and that's the thing that NLTK offers a lot of customization. You can choose which algorithm you want to use. Okay, so maybe I can go to the differences that we have. I have created a presentation here, so let me present it to you. So the first difference we saw was Spacy is object oriented, NLTK is mainly a string processing library. Okay, Spacy provides most efficient algorithm for a given task, whereas in NLTK you have an option. It's like using a manual camera versus prefix setting. So Spacy is like your mobile phone, you know, you have prefix setting, you take a picture, the picture is usually very good. NLTK is more like a manual DSLR camera, which gives you a lot of control, but then you have to select specific settings. Okay, so that's what you're seeing here, that here when you hit import, you can import so many different tokenizer. Okay, I am going to import sentence, like the default sentence tokenizer, and I will say send tokenize the string. The string is nothing but this. And by the way, if you get any error such as punct is not downloaded, etc., you might, if you're using it for the first time, you might get an error and you will have to do something like NLTK dot download the default package, you know, punked. So you have to run this code if you are getting error at this point. You can also just run this code and let's see what happens. So when you run this, okay, let me show you. You will get this kind of window. And this window tells you that in NLTK, when you did pip install NLTK, it installed the base library, but it did not install all the packages related to different languages, related to different tokenization schemes and so on. You can install all of them manually by running NLTK.download. It will open you this screen and you can say, okay, all packages download, or you want to download specific packages. Your models, you know, like specific models like Word2Vec, these are like specific language specific models that you can download. You can also download a different corpora. Okay, like for different corpus, like WordNet, TreeBank, Twitter samples, see? You can download all of these as and when need arises. But for now, most likely you will need to run this sentence just once and it will work. Now, see here, this sentence tokenizer is not working really well because it said doctor is a separate sentence. See, it's an array with three sentences. 1, 2, 3. So it did not work well in doctor. And we'll look into this later. But the purpose of today's tutorial is to show you that NLTK is a string processing library. See, there is no object here. There is no object-oriented programming. You give string as an input. You get strings as an output. Same things with word tokenize. If you do word tokenize of this big statement, it will split the words from that statement. And again, it's not very perfect doctor dot. I'm not saying NLTK sucks here because see, this got it right in the first sentence. What I mean to say is NLTK is like a DSLR manual camera. You need to tweak. It can be a really powerful library. People use it in production in big companies. But you need to tweak it to satisfy your needs. Whereas Spacy, out of the box, it gives you the best algorithm, best option, and it works. Okay? So just by looking at this code, you realize Spacy is object-oriented. NLTK, again, see, word tokenize, you gave string as an input, you got string as an output. And that is the reason why here I'm saying is NLTK is mainly a string processing library. The other difference is Spacy is user-friendly. NLTK is also user-friendly, by the way, but just my personal opinion. I find Spacy to be little more user-friendly than NLTK. So that's the second difference. Spacy doesn't allow you to select specific algorithms. See, when you're doing tokenization, you can do tokenization in 5 different ways. Spacy will select the best way for you. It's like taking picture from cell phone, you know? It just takes a best picture for you. Whereas an NLTK, you can customize, you can choose which algorithm you want to select. And hence, like Spacy is a relatively new library and it is, on many occasions, you will find it performs better than NLTK. Now, since NLTK allows you to do a lot of customization, it is perfect for researchers. Whereas Spacy, if you want to get things done, you know, you don't worry about too much about the algorithms and all that, go for Spacy because it is based for app developers. And Spacy is a new library, has a very active community, whereas NLTK is old library and the community is not as good as NLTK. And here is the summary of the differences. I hope you like this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. I'm putting a lot of effort in making this tutorial so you can share it with your friends, especially share this entire series on LinkedIn if you're liking it so far. In the next video, we are going to come up with a new topic. Hopefully, we'll write more code. Thank you.